This adventure is very, very new to me. The longest hike I've done before this was 4 or 5 hours, so that 21-hour hike was brutal, but really rewarding. The hike really strengthened our bond. We had to just keep pushing, and we were just talking to each other. We were just trying to keep our mind off of the pain. We canoed for like about 5 to 6 hours. It was pretty difficult. It was pretty difficult.
We got some roots coming up underneath the debris.
We had to pick up our canoe and drag it across, just across a dam or something, which was rough. And kayaking was actually really fun. It was almost like whitewater rafting with more direction, and you're on your own as well.
We're here, Lake Cheer of the Clouds. This is the first water sample testing we're gonna do.
The science component of this trip, I think, is really important because we get to see on what part of the Hudson River is the water quality actually changing. So we are taking, I think it was 24 samples of the Hudson River, and we're just seeing what affects the quality of the water, which I think is really interesting. The climate crisis has really changed and opened up a lot of people's minds in this new generation. It's really important to see that here, just being in the wilderness for so long, we can see the firsthand effects. And that's why I think that this generation is changed and has opened their eyes to what we can actually see affects climate change. This trip has been really impactful for me, just because I've never done anything remotely close to this. I'm really starting to see the benefits of it.
And this is why we do expeditions, the 10 scale. So 0 to 10. So 10 being the most elevated, life-giving moment of your life. Joy-filled, feelings of unwavering love and accomplishment.
I definitely think I'm gonna come out of this a changed person and reap the benefits from it. I've never pushed myself this hard in my life, and now I know I can do, it felt like on the hike, 200%. I think organizations like Mountain Goat Movement are really important for youth like myself or in high school, just because it really shows you grit and perseverance. And it helps you understand what your capabilities are. I did it for 14, 15 straight days without a break. You know, every day was a real challenge, and I think that's what kids need nowadays, to really show them what their potential can be.
Let's go, Cole.
On an expedition, we experience the depth of life, 0 to 10. And the only commonality between these numbers, 0, 1, 2, all the way up to 10, is that you never live in one number. It's only a moment.
This trip changed the way I see myself and my 100%. The whole trip, I've kind of thought about it as I'm going my 100% right now. On the first day of biking, I persevered and I pushed, and I think I really did hit my 100%. I was really happy about that I could find myself, and that's the main thing that changed, me finding myself and the most I can do. I think the nature of hanging out in the wilderness and just being around each other 24/7, being at each other's highs and lows, really impacts our friendship and how we can persevere and just kind of accepting each other for their worsts and their bests.
14 days ago, a group of strangers, now a group of brothers. We have this one moment, this moment right now, to have a day where we chase the tens. So when we get back on our bikes right now, and whatever this day holds, just keep that in the back of your mind. We are here to chase the tens.
When I look back on this trip in the future, I know I'll remember the connections I've made with the rest of the guys. Just spending 15 straight days with them has really bonded us, and I feel like they're my brothers now. And it's really cool, and I'll always remember that.